Hello, everybody. I'm STV and we are in motion. In this tutorial, we're going to take a look at our newest pack, OrnaMental. I'm about to show you how I prepare a deck for a show, how to make some visuals audio reactive, how to create loop variation using the Resolume built-in tools, and for dessert, we'll see what effects can give us even more variations and turn this look into something completely new, shiny, glowing in the dark. Alright, let's start. I like to think about the composition in a cinematic way, meaning it has a background and foreground, it has center and it has sides. Let's start with the center. This can be a center and this can be a background for it. If we want to add the foreground, this is in the foreground, and we can add some stuff in the sides, this one or this one to go and come in. This will aid me in creating clear and interesting compositions and hopefully not overload the output, like some VJs do, but not you, of course. I'm taking advantage of the DXV3 codec in Resolume that can contain alpha channels. Clips with alpha channels have built-in transparency. No more auto mask, luma key, or using blending modes unless you want to use them. You can get a clean look similar to broadcast look in real time. Alright, let's build a new deck from scratch. We'll start with importing loops. Let's take 1 to 10 first, and we'll take 11 to 20 and put them below. Next stage, we're going to put the layers in the right places. This one is a center layer, we can put it in the center. This one is a center as well. Let's put it in the center layer. This one is a background. Let's put it in the background below. This one is another center loop. Let's put it in a place. This one is center as well. This is a background loop. Center, you can see the center loops are not touching the edges. This is a background loop. This is a background as well. Background loops are filling the whole frame. This is a background as well. And center loops, they are intact. This one is a center as well. Let's place it here. This one can be a foreground. Let's put it here. This is another center layer. This one can be in motion. This one can be a background. And another side. This one is another background. This one should be a background. Another background layer. And this is a center element. Great. Now, let's scale down all the center elements, because when I created them to fill all the screen almost, and we don't need them that big, so 70% is enough for this kind of layer to fit well in the composition. I'm control dragging a layer, duplicating it, and I would like to give it a bounce using the BPM sync. Let's set the maximum size to 130 and the minimum size to about 60. Let it bounce. One more important thing is to give it a little bit of ease in and ease out, which will make it really bouncy. That's great. Now I'm going to repeat this process for each one of these layers on the center. I've repeated this process and now I've got the original layer and next to it the bouncy layer. I can choose the speed of the bounce by dividing or multiplying the bit. When the clips are set this way, I can use the original clip when the music is slow, and I can use the bouncy version when the beat drops or when the music is really intense. Now let's set up the next layer, in motion layer. For this clip, I'm going to change the rotation Z to 90. and I'm going to deal with the layer itself. I'm going to change the transfer setting for position X. I'm going to get it and drag it to the right. And now when the layer is on the right, I'm going to find the effect mirror and I'm going to drag it below the transform properties. I'm going to activate the mirror to split it in half. And now if I'm moving the X position, it can animate. Let's see, 450 pixels to about 700 pixels. Let's automate it now. So first, of course, easing in and easing out to make it bouncy and BPM sync. Let's set it to what we saw before. It was about 450 and the end is going to be about 700. And the last thing, we're going to make it bounce. Now we have a nice animation on this layer. If we take a different clip and we drop it on the same layer, it will still retain this animation. Let's try another clip, for instance. Control dragging to copy. And now we can already see some composition building up. It started to get interesting. And really, from now on, it's just pure fun. You just choose clips and you see what happens. Let's try this one. I love it when the center bounces and the side moves together. So beautiful. And all the transport animation is done by the software itself. I will repeat this process of trial and error, loading clips to my InMotion layer and seeing what happens. And let's do it really fast. I've loaded a few clips to the InMotion layer. Let's see how it looks with the center element. And really all I did was to take a clip, place it on the InMotion layer, put some background, put some center element, and see how it works together. Let's add some background element. And this is the same layer, just with the rotation on the Z. So we're starting to see a really nice composition that we can build live. And I think it's time to move to the foreground layer. Foreground layers can be simply in the foreground and we're gonna have a background element behind them. They can as well reveal the background, as you can see with this clip. Let's put a yin yang and another background behind it and let it reveal it. Just like this. That's an interesting way to use it. Or we can take a particular clip and do something very similar to what we did in the InMotion layer, but we're going to do it only on the clip itself. Let's take this clip and change the rotation. Then on position Y, I'm going to drag it upwards and drop our mirror. It's important to make sure that the mirror is below the transport. And we're going to put a mirror, and then on the transport settings, we're going to find what is exactly the height that we would like to have it. And this is like minus 350 up to minus 500. Let's create an animation here, dragging the easy ease in and ease out and doing the BPM sync. You know the drill. This is going to be minus 350 and this is going to be minus 500. Let it bounce. I'm about to find out what other layers fit in a foreground layer and we'll be back. I've created some variations on our foreground layer. Let's go through them and see some of them. Some of them are bouncing, like these ones. It can work well with the center element. This clip can go well with this clip. some of the clips I made to just rotate and to not bounce, like this one or this one, and let's add an element to it. Some of the layers are left as they are, just to reveal something behind them. This one can work well with the yin and yang. This is another original file. I found it's nice to have it reveal what's inside. This is another interesting example. I just used half a circle, and using a mirror and changing the Y position, I made it to reveal. It's like a hatch in the screen that things can be inside it, and this is another example. Some other interesting combinations we can create. Let's see this one. Let's solo this layer so we can see exactly. This is a layer, I just changed the position and rotation. The layer below it, also change of position rotation along with the mirror. And I can trigger both of the layers by column trigger. And let's see how it mixes. And speaking of the column trigger, sometimes you just want to change everything in just one click. So you can use the column trigger. And if you prearrange the visuals in the right slots, you can get really nice combinations, ready-made with just one click. I've excluded the foreground layer from the column by ignore column triggering, because I don't want to overload the composition. I can always add the foreground layer later. Alrighty, we've digested quite a lot here. It's time to move on to the dessert. Let's see what effects we can use to make this awesome look totally different. I found that adding a drop shadow to the composition really enhances and gives a fake depth. Let's take this drop shadow and drop it on each one of the layers. You can download the drop shadow effect on Resolume website. I'll give a link in the description. And straight away, it gives more depth, really subtle shadow, but it really helps to give a fake volume and to differentiate between the layers. I can give the composition more depth if I change the black background to something different. Let's open another layer by inserting a layer below the background. Let's add a solid color to the first slot. Let's change this red color. Let's decrease the saturation to zero and lower the brightness and get it a little bit like grayish. Then let's add from the effects the vignette and drop it on the clip. I like it. I just like it like this. We could end the tutorial here and that's it. But let's try and get some colors into the composition. Let's open a web page with Adobe Color to have the color wheel in front of us. And we can choose between analog, monochromatic, triad, and so on. I like for some reason compound. If I will spin the wheel, that's what will happen when I will hue rotate later. I like this color scheme. I will try to imitate it now on Resolume. Back in Resolume, let's close this gray background layer and let's add an edge detection. Edge detection just stays the way it is. Let's drop a tint effect. The tint effect, you leave the opacity at 1. Black hue is 0.68. Black saturation 0.68 as well. Black brightness 0.05. White hue is 0.68. White saturation 0.65 and white brightness 0.88. Next one will be exposure. The exposure, we're going to set it at 1 and we're going to add another exposure to take out the whites. And we're going to set it at 0.75 and we're going to drop a U rotate in the end of this stack and set it to 0.20. This will be the pink color that we have on the color wheel. And now I will go and copy the effects from this layer, the background layer, and I will copy them to all of my other layers. We're back. We have each one of the layers has all the effects on it in the same stacking. Let's take the center layer and change its hue rotation to be turquoise, dark turquoise, 0.80. This is the color. Let's take another layer, the in motion layer, and change the hue rotate for this layer as well to 0.63 to get the green. And the last layer will be our foreground. And we'll change it to be the purple, 0.06. Great. Now that we have this color scheme, we can take a hue rotate, drop it on the composition. And now if we'll move the hue rotate, we'll have the same color scheme like we did before, and it looks beautiful. We can up the saturation scale a little bit if we want it even more saturated. And the best part is that if we want it analogous or monochromatic, we can just reduce the hue scale and have a main color, a very important thing when you're trying to create a harmony with the light jockey. Okay, so let's wrap it up. I've showed you today how to prepare a deck for a show. We've learned how to create an appealing composition by setting the layers to be background or foreground, center or side. We learned how to duplicate clips and make clip variations in order to add versatility to your deck and enjoy playing. How to make some of the clips audio reactive, ready for that beat drop, and it's gonna come. And how to stack effects in order to colorize and make a look that fits one style of music fit other style of music. I'm sure you can come up with more tricks and looks just by spending some time trying out different combinations with different styles of music. To me, preparation is key. A well-prepared VJ can express himself and the music better and faster. Go out there and amaze the crowds. Make it a night they will not forget. Spread your love for visuals to your viewers and make it a colorful world. I'm STV and today we were in motion. Check out our website at stvinmotion.com for more of this goodness. Let's wrap it up with some music and jamming. See you next time.